Good day, everybody. Today I'm going to share with you some video that I've recently taken. And at the same time, I want to share with you some of the Lake Mead water database graphs and see if somebody is as confused or if anybody else is as confused as I am about the data that I'm going to share with you. If you find this content interesting or useful, would you mind reaching down and mash the like and subscribe? And if you wouldn't mind, share it out with your communities so more people can see the video. And maybe we can get some better answers in the comments to what's going on. It's beyond me why in the latter parts of the summer months, the lake levels can be continually going up. And we're still making releases. We haven't got any rainfall really to speak of, or there's definitely no snowpack to be melting. Nothing significant that should be making the difference. So the first graph here is showing you that it's the water summary, and the date ended on October 5, 2022, and the lake reading is at 1,045.32. The second graph here is for the entire year, and it's showing the last 14 measurements that we're taking, obviously just recently, and you can see where the lake levels in the upper part of the graph have gone up. I blew up the ending portion of the graph so you can see from the July 23rd roughly to October 5th, the lake elevations have continued going up. So what's the purpose for that? It's been going down drastically, 23 feet from the beginning of the water year up until the middle part of July. And then all of a sudden the lake level started going up. So, you know, what is the explanation to that? In this shot right here, I parked my drone at 175 feet up in the air, and that's where the actual water level should be at full pool. And looking down at my pickup, you see how far down that actually is. Now these next graphs I'm going to share with you show the dates from September 12th to September 25th. You'll see where the inflow is and the outflow on the graphs. And on this graph, it picks up from September 22nd and goes up to October 5th. And if you notice, the inflows are all significantly higher than the outflows. And these outflows are significantly lower than what they have been historically. And I'm going to show you a graph that shows that as well. Giving you a little look over Hemingway Harbor right now, just for a little break. And in this slide right here now, it shows you all the way from the year 2000 up to 2023. So you can see here, at no point is the releases ever less than like 10,000 cubic feet a second. Just look at this graph. Pause it so you can have a good look at it. It's pretty amazing that we've cut that drastically, or is the government doing something differently with the water? I don't have an explanation for it, but I see the lake going up. So somebody's doing something right. And is it the cuts that they've been making for the 2023 year? The all-time average outflow since it was filled is 11,099.89 cubic feet a second. And currently over the last 2 years, 2021 was 12,400 outflow, 2020 was 11,200 outflow. And we're down just in the last 14 days was 7,500 cubic feet a second. So it's a major drop. Tell me why. If you found this content interesting, please reach down and mash the like and subscribe and share with your community if you would. It doesn't cost you anything to subscribe to us, and it helps us a lot. Thank you very much. If you made it this far into the video for watching, we appreciate you very much. Thank you.